Okay, so good morning, everybody. Well, today we plan to do a couple of more functions like we have been doing in the previous classes. So today my aim is to cover the functions within the count family and the if family in order to make you understand more about the functions in a correct manner. Let me bold the sheet and let me also increase the font size so that it is visible clearly. So in the count family function, we have sub functions like we have just count, we have count a, we have count blank, we have count if, and we have count if s. So today my plan will be to cover some initial functions of the count family before I move on with the if function and sub functions within the if function. So let's start with the count family functions first of all. So as a practice, I make a very small sheet with me, which I'm going to use for using the count function. So over here, I have the first as serial number, then I have the name, and then I have marks 1, marks 2, and marks 3. In the serial number, I only have, say, 5 students in my class. Or let me make it as 10 so that they are countable. Let me write the names: Phil, Tom, Maddie, Jillian, Scott, Scotty, Sita, and Ram. Now they have got the total maximum marks are, let me write MM. They are 50. And from 50, these are the marks in the three subjects that people have got. So randomly, I'm going to write marks. Some people have got 50 as well. Some have got 36. Some have got 46, like that. Right? Similar manner, I'm going to just copy these marks in order to fill my data set. And then I'm going to work on the count function and then on the if function as well. Similarly, let me write some more data over here. So one person has got 15 also, 26 also, and 28 and 29. So this is a very small data set which I have made, and I'm going to use a count function to count the number of items in the data set which I have got. So as I normally do it, the moment I write count function in the Excel, it will tell me the meaning of each individual count function. So count function will basically count the number of cells in a range that contain numbers. Count A, on the other hand, will also include the number of cells in a range that are not empty. In count blank, it is going to count the cells that are blank. And in count if, we can give a condition for counting the data items in a particular data set. So let's give the count function first of all. And I have got the value. First of all, I'm going to give a C column and then I press enter. So as it is visible, there are total 10 values in my data set for marks 1 column. So I got 10 as the answer over there. Let me do it one more time. Now I want to select the three columns altogether, and then I will count and complete the function. And then I got 30 as the answer because indeed in three columns there are 30 values. Let me do one more thing. Now what I do, I'm going to include the serial numbers, name, apart from the marks in the three subjects. So this time I have got the answer as 40. Let me just see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It should have been 50, but this particular answer is telling us that count function will not consider the values of the string or text in a particular cell. So this particular cell, that is B column, where I have written the names, that has not been counted by the count function. Now let me use count A function. A basically means count all. So if I just write and have the range as the whole data set, and I close the bracket, and I'm going to get the answer as 50. Let me see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and I've got 50 as the answer over here. In a similar manner, if I just do count A with maybe only few columns, not with the whole column, but just with text as well as with a numeric value, and I'm going to end the bracket, and I'm going to get answer as 20. Let me do it one more time. I have count A, and now I'm going to select only the numeric values, and I will get answer as 30. Let me write another variable as date, and let's see what we get in that case. So I have a couple of options over here, and I'm going to simply copy them in order to fill the cells which I have over here. And now I'm going to see whether count function will consider the count of the date or not. So I will just do the count function in the first level. So I say count, and I write this function as count bracket, and I select the two columns where one column is having numeric value and the other column is having the date values. Let's see what we get. So it has considered date as well whenever I'm using the count function, but it will not consider the text value. So that means the count function will count the number, it will count the dates, but it will not consider the text values. In a similar manner, we have, I was saying writing count, and let me use this. And I get 20 as the answer. Let me do the same with count A as well. And I say count, and I consider the columns with the number as well as with the date. And I'm going to enter, and it is going to consider a date in that case as well, right? So we can do it one more time. We say count A, and this time I'm going to consider the, wait, there is an error. I didn't put the bracket, so it has given me the error. Put this whole range in the count A function, and I get 60 as the answer, because I can see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 60 indeed is the right answer. Now let me try this with the count blank option. I consider blank. It is going to count the number of empty cells in a particular range or cell which I consider over here. Now let me select the whole range, and let's see what we get. So as of now, the answer I'm getting as 0, because there is indeed no empty cell in this particular range. Let me try deleting some names, and let me see whether I get that answer or not. So as I'm deleting the data values in the individual cell, you will see that those particular cells have been added together. As of now, there are 5 total cells that are having the blank values or no values at all. So count blank has given me the answer as 5. In a similar manner, I can also use count if, where I want to put a condition. Let's say C, let me put the range. So the range is from C4 to C13. And then I say comma, I say greater than, let me say 30. And I close the bracket. So I get 7 as the answer. Let me just read what I gave. In the count if, I want to count all the values that are greater than 30. So if I just count, it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So in this count if function, what I've done, I've combined the count function with the if function. And the counting will happen only when this particular criteria is met in the individual cells. So in all the cells, wherever I have the value greater than 30, it will give me count only of those numbers. Now in this case, one thing more I want to tell you, that I didn't give any cell name over here before the operator. I can also give that. For example, if I just write C4 colon C13, and I write that as 30. Let's see what I get. So I will not put the bracket over here, but I will get zero answer. But certainly when you're working with the higher versions of the Excel, this particular problem will not come up, right? Again, I got the answer as zero. So let me remove that column from here and let me go back to my original formula, that is quotes greater than 30 and quote close and close the bracket. So that is the advantage of using COUNTIF function. If I just change this number as 40, let's see what we get. I've got now 5. Let me just see. It is 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So total values that are more than 40 are 5, and accordingly it has given me 5 as the answer. So that was all for the count family function. Next, we will talk about the IF function in the other video. Thank you so much for watching.